Ooh. And we are live. How you doing, comic fam? Oh, it's good to be here. And who am I sitting with?
This is Russ Bright from Milgi Comics. Good to see everyone tonight.
All right. We had something totally out of left field happen, and we are coming to the mic, and we're chatting about it. We got to do it right now, because this is some crazy stuff. I was not expecting this. We have been talking about Walking Dead for a long time. Since we really started this channel and started talking about comic books. So before we go any further, I want to let everybody know right now that we're talking spoilers. We're talking spoiler talk.
Like, big this spoilers.
We're going to get into the ending of Walking Dead, the comic book.
Yep.
I mean, I feel like putting it in the title that The Walking Dead has ended, that's no surprise.
People have been talking about this for a while. We know Kirkman tweeted out something cryptic on Monday. If you don't know that Walking Dead is ending by now, yeah, it's ending. But we're about to get into some serious, serious spoilers. So cover your ears, cover your eyes if you don't want to watch. Otherwise, we're about to get into it.
That's right. And comic fam, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. We do need your support. Hit that like button while you're here. It does go a long way. And yeah, all right. So we're going to talk about issue 193. One last chance. We are talking spoilers. Click off the video in 5, 4, 3, 2. We begin issue number 193 with a huge spoiler because we know Rick is dead. He's dead. All right, Rick is dead. But instead of continuing the story in that way, we start off the story with this picture. We have a grown Carl. Carl, this is a future. We have jumped into the future. Whoa. Okay, so this has definitely hit us by surprise. As soon as you opened up this page, Russ, I think you called me.
Yeah, I did. Yes, absolutely.
All right, so we have a jump cut to the future and an oversized issue. Okay, what's going on in this? Well, we have Carl, who is killing a zombie, and the synopsis of this story is that how does humanity overcome the walkers? How does this whole story end? It ends with humanity winning. Just time passes. Jump into the future. We have Carl as an old man, and this is a story about him killing a walker that is property.
Right.
This is a story about Carl killing this walker and then going to trial because somebody owns this walker. This is a future now where society hasn't just repaired itself. They have actually gone as far as owning these walkers because they're so scarce that it's almost a novelty to have them around.
Wow.
Okay. We also then continue with the trial of Carl because he has to go to court to face this crime that he's committed. He's dealing with a crime. Things have changed in this world. We also have Michonne, not going by Michonne anymore, and a number of other characters that we see make it in the future. This is a happy ending. We have Michonne, now known as Judge Hawthorne, because if you remember, she used to be a lawyer. So she rules the case that Carl's okay because she knows that their history. And then we see the impact of Rick to this whole society. There's a statue, and Russ, you pointed out before we started this.
Yeah, this is actually the silhouette cover from 191. So if you look at the cover for 191, you can actually see Rick with his, you know, amputated hand raised up. So this is a very poignant moment. And again, this is kind of harkening back to just two issues ago, how big of a turning point 191 was for the series.
Then we move on to another very interesting reveal. And that is that we have a Carl that's older. We have a Carl that has seen a lot. But we also have a Carl with a daughter. And one thing that he mentions in this story here is that Carl's daughter has never seen a walker.
Right.
This is really the ultimate testament to his father, to Rick, and what he wanted for not just everybody he met, not just the bad people that he met, but for his son specifically, for him to live a life that was like they remembered. And we end the series with him reading Walking Dead to his daughter.
Right. You know, your grandfather, Rick, was a wonderful person. I'm going to tell you about the story of your grandfather. And it feels kind of meta. I mean, it's definitely one of those like story within a story type things, but wrapped up nice with a happy ending. I mean, okay, this is about as happy as I think that they're going to be able to get. The people living in the Walking Dead town, they just don't really remember the walkers and don't remember what happened. And it's a novelty. It's an interesting way to go about this, you know?
Russ, as a store owner, catch me up. This is a ruckus. What has the last couple months of Walking Dead been, in case the community wants to know? How did we get to this point? Because no one knew this was coming.
Well, this is the crazy thing. Now, as a shop owner, a lot of times people think that we get extra information, and we don't. And sometimes we get wrong information. This is the biggest one that I've ever seen with the most wrong information.
For real.
We knew that in 191, Rick got shot.
Right.
We knew that in 192, he got turned and died. I mean, these are two big things. About a month ago on the CBSi Hot 10 list, 192 spiked. We were seeing him sell for about $15.
I mean, it hit that $15 mark, which is really what Walking Dead books routinely would go for if there was any hype whatsoever.
Right.
Okay.
And I mean, in the last 7 years that I've had a shop, there have been a lot of Walking Dead books that just spiked and have hype, and that's what happens. They have been going up, and we knew that very, very quickly it had to go back to press. And when it went back to press, they were going to give it a commemorative cover. So they had the commemorative cover for 192 that actually came out, or comes out tomorrow.
We're recording this Tuesday night.
Yes, so Walking Dead, second print, 192 with the commemorative Rick Grimes. Now, this is where it gets a little bit dicey. So they told us that 193 comes out the same week that 192, and that our orders are 100% returnable. They normally do this when you have a major event. And the idea is that they want shops to up their orders. They want you to order as many possible copies because they know if it doesn't sell, you'll be able to return it. Now, the confusing thing is that they had already solicited 194 and 195.
Yeah, let's bring up this because why did they do this?
It was supposed to be a new character coming out, and then even in 195 we have a talking about an even different character, the Swordsman. So we were talking about a new character coming out in 194, a different character coming out in 195. Charlie Adler actually was told to draw covers for books that they knew wouldn't get released. They actually had a synopsis and description for the books that wouldn't get released, and it still looks like on Diamond's website that I can order 194 and 195 to be able to come out in the next 2 months. Well, we know that this isn't true. 193, again, end of the story. It's stupid hot right now. We're seeing buy it now. Someone apparently has pre-sold 500 copies of it at $17.99, but there are also copies going for $3.99, which is cover price. So there's a lot of fear of missing out right here. There are a ton of copies out there. With full returnability, there's going to be a lot of copies. I wouldn't be surprised if this was a 500,000 copy, like a 500,000 copy print run. I mean, really, you know, this is something that I wouldn't necessarily want to say that, you know, invest heavily in, but to go find a copy.
Okay, so that's a very interesting turn of events over this last few months.
Mm-hmm.
Ups and downs. We had major reveals in the story, and then to all of a sudden be led to this point where we're given an oversized issue here. Do me a favor. Let me know what your feelings are about the ending of Walking Dead. Do you have any memories of The Walking Dead? I remember reading this series for like months. I had that big old, you know, like the oversized.
Yeah, the compendium.
Yeah. And we know we'd read that weekly on vacation. I got a lot of good Walking Dead memories. We're going to be giving away this copy of issue number 193, the final Walking Dead issue. Just put a comment in the comment section below and we'll be doing a raffle. Shout out to Key Collector for this post here. CNN breaking news that Marvel Comics closed the deal on The Walking Dead. CNN, you got to learn your comics. Yeah, Image Comics. We were just kidding. Marvel is not doing anything with this. And apparently they're bringing back Marvel Zombies. I don't think that this is relevant news at all, but I thought it funny.
I think it's very interesting.
I think
yes,
it's pretty funny.
Absolutely.
good job, CNN. Why did this happen? We don't know for sure, but at the end of this book, there is like a six-page letter from Kirkman.
Mm-hmm.
Him going over the key points of how we ended here. The first thing to take away, if we go by what Kirkman says, is that he was just done. Mm-hmm. He just didn't have more story left, and that he was struggling up until this point.
Right.
And he actually had plans to end this in the issue right around that issue number 70, I mean,
well
Alexandria.
Before Negan, well before a lot of these other characters that ended up getting developed and stuff that was happening in the TV series. But by the time he hit issue number 70, it was very clear that he needed to keep going. It was that popular. It was enough of a juggernaut that, yeah, he's going to milk that cash cow as long as he can. And again, it's his baby. This is his big baby and his big project.
He also mentions that he feels a little regret. He's not even sure if he made the right decision. This is definitely something that they've been throwing around for the last couple of years. And he specifies a couple of years now that him and Allard had been talking about this, the artist, and they've been going back and forth on how are we going to end it. And he even goes as far to mention that he wanted to give it a happy ending. Speculators up until today were convinced that they were going to end this series, and then they were going to see something else pick up. Mm-hmm. Maybe Negan would take on the story. Maybe we would see this Rick section end of The Walking Dead, but we'd stay in the world and move on right to something else.
Well, and we've got 20 years now because of this issue that Carl has shown middle-aged Carl with a, 6 to 8 year old daughter or something to that effect. So, I mean, this would be a perfect opportunity to go, how do we get this breakdown? How did we get actually here and tell the other 20 years of Carl's story? Because we got Rick's story, why don't we just do Carl's story? That would make logical sense.
It makes sense. That's if you go on YouTube, those are the videos that have been out over this last week. And
oh my goodness,
I almost died. That's on camera.
Don't die.
Oh my goodness, did you see that? That thing just almost smacked me in the freaking face. Wow, that's never happened, and this is live.
I'm so glad you don't need stitches,
finish
Tom.
I don't care. We're finishing. This is how we do it. We have to get this out. Yeah, you would think that that's a potential of how this would end. And you know what? That's not how it ends. And he says it in the book, in the end, in the newsletter section. That
the very lengthy 7-page letter that Robert Kirkman writes to people at the end of the book. Yes.
He said that this is that's going to be like that. He said that this is something that he had planned, and we are not going back to this world.
Mm-hmm.
That this is done. And P.S. Negan lives. He just throws that in there at the end. And I love it. I love that he did that. But the fact of the matter is that regardless of what he says, the speculation now, and this is my speculation, is that The Walking Dead, as of the last 4 months, the press on the show has been nothing but the original director from season 1 to most of season 2 taking AMC to court. $300 million lawsuit.
Mm-hmm.
2 years ago, Robert Kirkman taking AMC to court over Walking Dead and money earned and demanding more.
Right.
You know, this has been an ongoing battle. I remember Emerald City Comic Con, all right? Emerald City Comic Con, the first time I met Robert Kirkman, the first time I met Tony Moore, they had to be on other sides of the whole floor. Like, they specifically had an issue with each other, so much to the point where Robert Kirkman had to be in a position on the floor where he would not run into Tony Moore. And Tony Moore had to be on the other side of the convention hall because there was so much weirdness with lawsuits over this title. What happened over the last 2 years? We have Amazon picking up all of Robert Kirkman's titles now, except for Walking Dead.
Mm.
The Walking Dead is owned by AMC. And what have we been saying over this last year? Nonstop. AMC is never letting go of The Walking Dead.
No, they won't. They're going to make as many offshoots as possible of everything that they can.
Which is why he publicly has been saying that Walking Dead isn't going anywhere on AMC.
Mm-hmm.
But we definitely didn't think it would end like this.
Right.
Definitely didn't think I'd be ending this show with the freaking microphone in my hand. But you know what? That's how it goes. Hit that like, hit that subscribe button. Thanks for listening today, Comic Fam. And we want to hear your thoughts about The Walking Dead ending. We want to hear your thoughts about, whether you think this is actually over.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe he's just messing with us and he is going to do something.
Right.
I don't think so. We want to hear from you. Let us know.
Awesome.
All right. As always, Comic Fam.
Geek responsibly.
Enough said.